It doesn't matter if you're a beginner editor or more advanced, you probably have ended up with some errors or problems or issues while editing. And if you haven't yet, there is a good chance that you will.
That's a little pessimistic, don't you think?
No one likes you. Okay. Hey guys, my name is Dylan, and today we're gonna jump right into it. Problem number one. Maybe you're editing and you decide that you wanna overwrite your B-roll clips that are sitting above your primary storyline and put them into the primary storyline. So you press Option Command and down arrow, but you notice now that your audio looks like it's split from your clip. And even if you press Command Z, you can't get it to be one again. Here is the simple fix. Click your clip and press Control S. Or you can right-click the clip and press Collapse Audio. Now, why would you want to use this feature though? This will allow you to keep the audio connected to the primary storyline clips in the same location while putting alternative footage into that same area in the primary storyline. So now you can have the audio from the inserted clip playing and the previous clip playing. It basically gives you a quick option to make J and L cuts and keep your timeline compressed to the primary storyline. Problem number two, you may have seen this scary red frame before. It's letting you know that the location of the clips or stills in your library has changed. The computer can't find it, and usually Final Cut does really well with finding clips. For example, with these, the hard drive that has this media on it isn't connected. Maybe you've moved that clip somewhere or deleted it or something got screwed up. So here's how to fix this issue. Click the event that has those missing files. You could also click the library, or if there's only one clip, just click the clip. Then go to File, Relink Files, Original Media, and Final Cut will let you know which files are missing here. All you'll do is click Locate All, find the files or a folder or hard drive that has the media on it if you can, and click Choose. Problem three is an importing issue. Sometimes you'll notice that you'll have a little camera icon in your footage in your library. And maybe some of the clips you can't even see, like this. They also could have another dreaded red frame as the thumbnail. Final Cut is just letting you know that something happened during the importing process and your clips weren't imported fully or properly. So what you'll do is plug in your SD card or hard drive again, whatever has that footage on it, and you'd think that since the clips are now visible and everything looks fine that you're good, but you're not. We need to re-import the clips by going to File, Import, and re-import from camera archive, and then click continue. Now those camera icons will go away and you'll see the importing process is starting again. Then you can eject your camera or SD card once it's finished. Problem number four, when this message pops up that says your storage device is almost full. If it says Macintosh HD, then first and foremost, stop editing off your computer's hard drive. Your computer's hard drive space is generally pretty limited, so you'll be screwing yourself the more you edit on it. Libraries will build, and pretty soon you'll get this message. A solid method to take is having a couple terabyte HDD hard drive to store media and old libraries on, and an SSD hard drive to edit on. I currently edit on a Samsung T5 and I have no complaints. I heard the T7 is great as well. How you'll set up saving to your external hard drive is create a library and select that external hard drive that you'd like to save to. Now with the new library selected, click the inspector window and click modify settings. Make sure the media is set to in library as well as cache. If you use Apple Motion a lot, then change this to in library as well. Now your projects will be saving to your external hard drive and not on your computer. It's also really beneficial to have your media already on some sort of external hard drive when you import it into Final Cut, because then you'll have an option to click Leave Files in Place. If you choose Copy to Library, Final Cut will duplicate those clips, taking up more space. Another helpful tip is to turn off background rendering. If this is on, chances are your hard drives are filling up a lot when they don't need to be. Click Command and Comma, head to Playback, and click Background Render Off. You'll render when exporting, so no need to slow up your editing workflow and fill up your hard drives even more. If there's a clip that's having trouble playing on your timeline, you can render that individual clip by selecting it and clicking Control R. Now, to make more space, we can delete render files, proxy media, and optimize media in projects that we're not using. You can always re-render or re-transcode later if you need to, so deleting these files isn't something that's irreversible. They just take up space. Click your library and go to File, Delete Generated Library Files, and delete what you want. If you're wondering what optimized or proxy media are, I will leave a link to a video I created about them in the description. One of the best investments I made for Final Cut was picking up Library Manager by Arctic Whiteness. This is a $37 app, and I can clear terabytes of space across multiple hard drives at the same time with the click of a button. It also helps me organize files as well. I'll leave a link to a video I created about it in the description as well. Problem number 5, your timeline now looks weird. You don't know what's going on. This is your precision editor, and it is open right now. The precision editor lets you fine-tune the edit point between two clips by giving you a visual representation of what's going on. This isn't something I use, but it could be helpful to see the effect that the cut or transition is having on your clips. Here we can see that everything to the right of this point is cut from the edit. I can move the cut here, and so on and so forth. To get back to your normal looking timeline, just click Escape. To re-enter your precision editor, click the connection point between two clips and double click. Problem number 6 is something that happened to me the other day, actually, and I'm curious to know if it's happened to you, so let me know in the comments. This is just a picture because I can't recreate this, but all of a sudden, all of your audio will disappear in your library, on your timeline. It'll look like your audio is loading, and it'll just show these lines. Now, you can still hear the audio, but you just can't see the waveform, and that is incredibly annoying when you are creating an edit. What I found was that this was just some glitch in the software, and I had to exit out and re-enter Final Cut 2 or 3 times, and then the waveform showed up again. I don't know why this happened, but that's the fix. Just exit and enter a couple times. The next problem is one I've seen in Facebook groups occasionally. People will comment, "What is wrong with my screen? It looks weird, and now I have this red box. I'm not sure what to do." All this means is that your viewing window is scaled in. You see, we can move this around to see our whole frame. To exit this, just click this number percentage and then fit. You can also click the viewer window and then click Shift Z. And this is the same shortcut that also lets you fit your whole timeline into view as well. The final issue that commonly arises is I made a compound clip in the past by pressing Option G, but I've decided I don't want this to be a compound clip anymore. So if this was one of the previous actions you took while editing, you could press Command Z to undo, but if it was much later, you can simply break the clips apart by pressing the clip and hitting Shift Command G. Alternatively, you could go to Clip and Break Apart Clips. Have any of these happened to you more than the others? I'm genuinely curious to know what's one of the most common issues that arise when editing. Also, I plan to make another video or two about other Final Cut Pro problems, so if you enjoyed this, do me a huge favor and let me know that you did in the comments below. Press the like button and make sure to take a look at my channel if you want to learn more about Final Cut Pro and creating videos in general. I will see you guys next week. Have a great one.